So where does it come from? First of all, we need to see that the standard calls for the implementation of a security management process that needs to be implemented. And that one includes security by design. Security by design means the consideration of security in the development process at the beginning and further down throughout the lifecycle of your product. We want that cybersecurity issues become discovered and resolved already from the earliest stage in the product lifecycle. As we all know, earlier issues are discovered, the easier and cheaper to mitigate them. So by design actually means in a conceptual way. So to be prepared for risks already at the time of designing. Every product has a life cycle, and accordingly, a TARA is a living document. At any time, you might ask yourself, do I need to adapt my risk analysis? Which entities are affected? And we believe the model-based approach fits this requirement very well. Rule-based modeling assistance that allows suggestions and recommendations that save you time and help to prevent errors. And in connection to the item definition, it even gives you an idea about the completeness of your analysis. In the situation before, there were no common cyber-related terminologies. There was no industry set of minimum criteria for effective cybersecurity in a vehicle. No standardized reference for the regulators to assess the robustness of the cybersecurity process, and also not for its assessment. And that in a situation of increased connectedness, where the possibility of updating software of potentially harming items and components is increasing. ISO 21434 demands specific requirements for cybersecurity risk management. UN ECE 155 demands specific mitigations that are not contained in 21434. It is a cybersecurity process framework, a common language to help manufacturers and organizations in general to communicate their cybersecurity risk. But it's not tied to any specific technologies or solutions. We provide tooling. It's called Security Analyst, and we provide services that support your cybersecurity processes. Thereby, we focus on the concept phase, clause 9, and threat analysis and risk assessment methods, clause 15. We can speed up your item definition and assist running your TARAs more efficiently. Reuse is needed and it's important. It saves time, it saves costs, and in most cases, a model import is absolutely possible without data loss. There is the Open XAM initiative that was started by us with the clear mindset to have a common exchange format for all security entities and to exchange them between tools and documents and allow an easy transition. Open XAM was designed with exactly this use case in mind. You may not only exchange complete TARAs, but also subsets. For example, just the damage scenario definitions. This is also true for the way back into your system in order to get to a whole vehicle validation. This is actually the most common customer requirement. And again, Open XAM is an important cornerstone by means of an adapter framework that we have created over the years, and through the built-in import of OpenXAM in the tool, we can make the existing information available in Security Analyst. The standard just defines a minimum set of criteria that actually may be extended over time. So we find it important that the tool that you use supports that level of flexibility. So the tool that you use should be adaptable according to the process. And that's exactly how it works with Security Analyst. Firstly, you want to build up inventories of your cybersecurity knowledge. One thing is building up centrally managed and version catalogs that contain pre-assessed threats and controls. And the security analyst approach is rule-based that allows automatic re-evaluation of your TARAs. With Security Analyst, you can visualize all TARA entities and their relations. You have an import-export functionality to reuse what is already there, and you have smart assistants that guide you through the process. Finally, you have in-tool tracing for continuous consistency and quality checks. Yes, of course, it's secure. It is locally stored and technically it's XML based. It means you own the data and you decide where to put it, such as into your private Git repository, through which again collaboration is possible. It does in the way that you can use the established software engineering workflow and in the way that you can exchange data easily using XM or any custom formats. It's also possible to merge in results at a later point.